Well, chemicals like cyanide and carbon monoxide were left from that heavy toxic smoke, so their levels had to be measured on every floor of the building before anyone was allowed to re-enter it. And today, over 80 of these big industrial fans, or air scrubbers as they call them, were hard at work while the real cleanup began. I did take a look down at that shooting range, and it's pretty clear that for employees of the Portsmouth Police Department, the impact is going to be felt for quite a while. Firefighters on scene Tuesday night were relieved to contain a basement fire to the shooting range at the Portsmouth Police Department.
When the call comes in that, hey, there's a fire at City Hall, it's at the police department, and oh, by the way, we have heavy black smoke. You know, a variety of different things come into your mind. Where is this spreading? What's involved? Is it normal combustibles?
Most of the damage done by heavy toxic smoke from smoldering rubberized shooting range backstop where the flames first started.
Some officers, or at least one officer, had been using it earlier in the night. Don't know if that's related or if it has anything at all to do with it.
The investigation is underway alongside top to bottom cleanup that will include gutting the entire range and tearing out other ceilings. Every surface of every floor of the building must be cleaned without police work missing a beat.
This is a massive impact for us, unfortunately. The nature of the fire and the backstop and the stuff that actually burned causes a level of toxicity on the walls and the ceiling and everything it touches. And unfortunately, our range is right near our locker room, so all the officers' lockers with all of their uniforms, all of our equipment, all have to be professionally cleaned. And it's not like just bringing it to the dry cleaners. So yeah, so we have some officers out today in jeans. You know, it's you're trying to make them look as professional as possible with not having uniforms, but.
But the good news is that's the only impact the public should see. The deputy chief says they're working with the fire department to determine the exact cause, and if for some reason it has to do with the use of the firing range, then they'll look at changing some of the protocols. Reporting live from Portsmouth, Jennifer Crompton, WMUR News 9.